London has always been closely identified with its river, navigable for seagoing ships right to the doors of its merchants. In the past, the river was a main highway for its citizens, and the town soon stretched far along its banks. To the east, the greatest growth took place, lining the banks with warehouses and docks, and the dwellings of the people who gained a living by the river. London and its port have grown together. Now, with a population of 8 millions, it has spread in all directions, absorbing towns and villages into what is today Greater London. To seaward of this great capital, the Thames curves northwards for a while at Galleon's Reach, with Greater London's last remaining undeveloped land on its south bank. Here, for over 300 years, the Royal Arsenal has been a reserve for the manufacture, development and storing of weapons. Today, hidden among the trees, are the derelict factories where munitions were once made. Grouped like villages are the abandoned offices and homes of many of the one-time Arsenal workers, and 3 miles of waterfront almost unknown to Londoners. When 1,000 acres of this area were released from their historic use, the Greater London Council, the biggest local authority in the world, took up the challenge and the chance to plan a new community for 60,000 Londoners and started work with the two London borough councils. Below Abbey Wood and the remains of Lesner's Abbey, the land was flat, open to the river's winds and very marshy in places. The GLC team wanted to shape these marshes into attractive canals and lakes for sailing. The existing water spaces were quite beautiful, and the aim was to integrate them into the landscaping scheme. That water adds to the visual interest of a place has been evident for years in many parts of London. And water became a main theme in the plan. Lakes linked by canals, and on the Thames itself, an international yacht harbour as a central feature of the new community, to be called Thamesmead, a name chosen in open competition among Londoners themselves. Planning began in 1964. A team of GLC architects and planners was formed. Ideas grew up and were revised, then abandoned sometimes for entirely new concepts. At first, the plan had to be as fluid as the great reach of the Thames, which was to form its northern boundary. Here is how the GLC team began to see Thamesmead, looking ahead into the 21st century and making the most of the opportunities the wide river offers. This model shows the town centre, culminating in the yacht harbour. The colours indicate to the planners the different uses of the buildings. Tall buildings are closely identified with the harbour to give as many people as possible the advantage of views of the marina and river. They also help in creating a balance between Thamesmead and the industrial building on the north bank. Areas away from the river are planned for fewer people to the acre, 2- and 3-storey dwellings with plenty of open space around them. To rely on existing communications would obviously have been impracticable, and the development of a main road plan was influenced by several factors. The proposed Sea Ring, a new motorway to link Thamesmead with the GLC's Greater London Motorway System and the National Trunk Roads. and the Spine Road, which connects the new development with Woolwich on the west and Erith on the east. But new roads are not going to result in this sort of chaos. At Thamesmead, the pedestrian will have an environment entirely of his own. Homes, schools and parklands linked by traffic-free pathways and walks. Walkways above the level of the roads will bridge traffic routes and link the whole area of Thamesmead to the town centre. With a 15-year building programme, work had to be planned stage by stage. By 1966, agreement to the immediate development of the eastern end of the site was reached. Work began in the autumn. Great attention is being given to landscaping. As the ground is prepared and the foundations and canals are dug, the landscape is being moulded to relieve its natural flatness. For instance, a mound which will stretch from Lesner's Abbey to the Thamesmead waterfront is being constructed ready for early planting of trees. The site is already being enhanced. Lawns are laid and trees planted even before the houses are built. Most of the housing is being built on pile foundations. These piles are driven into the ground to an average of 25 feet. One of the two lakes to be linked by canals is already under construction. This lake, with the sailing facilities it'll offer, will provide a decorative area of water covering some 30 acres, possibly more. It's also a factor in the preparation of the site, because with the canals, it's an important part of a highly organized land drainage system. Over many acres, the ground is being prepared. A mechanized army of modern builders is in action with its sophisticated machinery. Ponderous, powerful, and sometimes strangely prehistoric, they work to a carefully conceived plan. One of the first buildings to go up was a factory to manufacture prefabricated units for the multi-story blocks. By the end of 1967, the conventional housing could be seen growing above the surface of the ground. And the completed factory was beginning to supply the units for the taller blocks. These units are carried in specially designed trucks to the waiting cranes. At County Hall 2, headquarters of the GLC, the work goes on. Discussion, research, consultation at all levels, revisions, adjustments, improvements to plans and models. A Thamesmead Committee of members of the GLC and the borough councils was specially set up. 15 years of building work had to be planned, and the needs of a community demanding what will be considered the best in years to come have to be assessed now. A community development group has been formed to study and encourage community activities. For instance, the needs and pleasures of children and young people are a priority at County Hall and in the two boroughs. Education, recreation, sports and children's play, all vital needs of a growing, healthy, modern community are being built into the plan. Advantages of having local shops near schools, as well as in the central shopping areas, are also being fully realized. The work of a community study group ties in closely with the work of the Bexley and Greenwich councils and voluntary organizations in health and welfare service fields. A health center has been designed, and a medical research team is studying means of giving Thamesmead what may be Britain's most advanced health service organization and facilities. The spiritual needs of a future community are being given special consideration in the light of a new unity in the religious world. Many denominations have come together to seek ways of providing an ecumenical center which will be entirely new and forward-looking, both physically and spiritually. There'll also be provision for those who follow other traditional faiths. Employment will be provided. Local industrial estates and offices in the central area. Provision is being made for a great variety of houses and flats with equally varied arrangements for buying or renting. Opportunities for private enterprise in housing, in the development of the central area and the industrial estates are drawn into this tremendous concept. This is how the councillors, planners, architects, civil engineers had begun to see Thamesmead, a town of the 21st century. Stage one was to include a 30-acre lake, housing for about 5,000 people, its own local health center and schools, recreation and play areas. By 1969, plan and model started to become reality. Housing at the south end of Harrow Manor Way was the first to be completed and ready for occupation. And the Gooch family, making Thamesmead history, was the first family to move into a five-roomed maisonette on Coraline Walk. Here, Mrs. Gooch has a patio where the whole family can sit out and get the sun, when there is any. She has a modern kitchen adjoining a big lounge. For the first time, her daughter and her two boys have separate rooms and a study where they can all do their homework. Her daughter now has a long journey to her school in the New Kent Road, but Mrs. Gooch felt it would be wrong to move her from her grammar school, where she was very happy and doing well. Her youngest boy, Tony, goes to the new Thamesmead Primary School, which the Bexley Borough Council had finished and ready to take pupils simultaneously with the occupation of the first houses. Here, the older children are learning about the new town which is growing up around them.
All my pictures at the back.
Yes, all your pictures. All your drawings and writing at the front. Mm. Yes, that's better, Aunt Stephen.
Looks as though it's joined on there.
What are you doing, Steve?
Oh, just writing, you know, about 108.
At the moment, there are only a few pupils in each class. But as more families move into the area of stage one, the school population will grow. The council was determined that all the facilities for modern living should be included in the plan, and that these amenities would be ready for the very first tenants. A temporary health centre has been built, providing the early tenants and their families with the basic services. The needs of its inhabitants individually and as a community are being considered all the time. An information centre has been established with a community officer to deal with the anxieties and questions of newcomers.
Well, this is where we are at Abbeywood railway station, where you came off the train there and came up the road to Harrowmanor Way to here. Of course, the whole of this is Thamesmead, but the first stage of rebuilding now, of course, is here. And on this picture you can see your maisonette will be there on Coddlin Walk.
Yes.
And you will be able to do your shopping, of course, in Abbeywood by the railway station, which
yes.
I've been. But there's some more shops here on this shopping centre here. You can get to it on the pedestrian way. Yes. It's a club room and a medical centre.
Have we had the public house at all?
Oh, yes, there'll be a... There's a site for a public house there and another one there. Your primary school, of course, for the children will be here.
Yes.
But after, of course, when they've grown up, the whole this area will be built, of course. And we'll have polytechnics and other secondary schools.
Yes.
We'll also have these parks along the river. It's about 3.25 miles of riverfront, you see, so we've got plenty of...
By the beginning of October 1969, the first tower block was completed. At the opening ceremony, the building, in which there are 48 flats, was formally handed over by the building contractors to the Greater London Council. The foundation stone was laid by the chairman of the Thamesmead Committee, Mr. Seaton Forbes Cockell. The tenants in this block of flats, lucky enough to be on one of the higher stories, have a unique view across the lake and growing town to the distant bank of the Thames. Indeed, from the top of the block, you can turn from 19th century development to 21st century development here in stage one, where building is rapidly nearing completion. Beyond the buildings of Thamesmead and the adjoining older Abbeywood estate, work is going on in what were the old arsenal grounds. The river bank is to be reinforced. Civil engineers are diverting small rivers and cutting a way through the arsenal's wilderness for the spine road which will join Woolwich with Erith. And the new river crossing will be tunnelled beneath the Thames here at Tripcockness. The river will eventually be linked with Abbey Woods by a green walk. From this walk, not long ago a mound of earth, but now turfed and planted with trees, you can turn from the built-up areas of stage one to the advancing work of stage two. By the beginning of 1970, at the eastern end of Stage 2, the factories to provide members of the community with a variety of work were already up. Most of the 12 for the GLC have been let, and the first privately owned factory is nearly completed. A residents' association has been formed and meets regularly to discuss problems to do with housing, general facilities and social matters.
If these are not done within a suitable time, say lapsing a month, then bring them to committee and we will take them up from there. Are there any other points on this?
Mr. Chairman, could I just mention the fact that the communal stairs and windows seem to be miraculously cleaned just before the visit of VIPs to open the new tower blocks?
How much is due to our visit from the district committee and the visit of the VIPs is hard to say. But we do hope that in the future that these will get up to the standard they are at the moment. Are there any more points?
Well, what about the scaffolding?
We did ask in a roundabout way for this scaffolding to be erected, i.e. the waterproofing of dwellings. And
Chairman, the old point is that that scaffolding is right outside your bedroom windows. Well, dead easy for anybody to get up there and get in, you know what I mean?
Yes.
So that's the point.
Of course, you should be covered by insurance.
I'm not.
You're not. That's all that difficult. If there are no more questions on this point, we'll proceed with the rest. Play spaces.
Mr. Gibbons, I know that the play area is fully equipped. Could you let me know when the children can play on it?
No, we're given to understand that there's dispute with a plot of land, and until this is...
The GLC itself was instrumental in getting the tenants to set up their own independent association, with obvious benefits to both tenants and council. Inevitably, in the early stages of Thamesmead, much of what is discussed is based on the teething problems common to any new development. Many of the problems discussed here are already solved. There will, of course, be others, but the channels of communication between tenants and the three councils have been established and are in full operation. A Thamesmead Christian Association of all denominations identifies itself in the broadest way with the welfare of the people and the many facilities the growing town will offer them. In the meantime, visitors from all over the world are coming to Thamesmead. Governor Romney from the United States is one of the many overseas visitors to see Thamesmead growing from the plan which won in 1969 the coveted Abercrombie International Architectural Award. A plan for a community already coming to life, which in concept reaches out to the next century. Many years of work have yet to be done. Great areas of land have to be cleared, drained, and molded into the shape envisaged by the architects and planners. Soon, Stage 3 will begin to take shape. Although only a model now, it will shortly become a part of this modern community. A community born of the efforts of both private and council development, where 60,000 people will live in environmental conditions unmatched by anything that has existed before. Thamesmead, with its own identity, but still a lively part of London, growing from the river, the changing Thames.